Hello friends, today we have planned to discuss about the characteristics of the learners in the 21st century. All of us know that we are at a very critical stage in the sense that our learners are in the age group of 18 to 25 in the higher educational system. And when we talk about the learners of the 21st century, we have already covered two decades in the 21st century. We are in 2020 now. That means bulk of the learners in the higher education system in this country, they are born in the 21st century. Now, what is the speciality or uniqueness of these learners who are born in the 21st century? That is the focus of this video. And I would say that in the 21st century, the learning environment has changed. We have a flexible learning environment where we say that anytime, anywhere learning has now become a reality with the intervention of information and communication technology in the sphere of education. So, in this new environment, which is basically a flexible environment, we have regular universities providing teaching in a classroom situation. We have open and distance learning systems, which is basically a flexible system, a learner-centric system. We have online method of education. We have blended method of education. So there is a flexible learning environment around us, and a student has to choose which one is more suitable as per their situation. Now, in this flexible learning environment, we very visibly see new learning styles. Because they are all born in the 21st century, we call them as digital natives. The others who are born in the later part of the 20th century can be called as the digital immigrants. So there is a big difference between the digital natives who are born with the technology and digital immigrants of the later part of the 20th century who have adopted technology. So these learners of the 21st century who are born with technology, they are more comfortable with different types of technology, be it your web technology or your mobile technology. They are more comfortable with social media, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn, or any other social media. They are more comfortable to learn e-content in a digital platform. They are more comfortable with YouTube videos. They are more comfortable to go to a chat room or a chat box in a digital platform or a discussion forum. And these are all natural for them. Unlike the digital immigrants of the later part of the 20th century who have to adjust and adapt to the new situation, the 21st century learners are more acquainted, more familiar with these new learning styles and learning environment. So that is the reason why I say that the 21st century learners are distinctly different from others. Another feature of the 21st century learners is that they are also after micro credentials. They want to have knowledge about many things because they are multitasking. They can be adaptable to the traditional method of education, but they are, as I say, they are comfortable with the digital method of education. So in the digital arena, there are a lot of micro credentials available, small modules, small programs which are available in the digital form, and they are after these micro credentials. So they want to add value to the degree that they are earning from the university. That is a unique feature of these new learners of the 21st century. And at the same time, as I said, they are multitasking. That means they want to earn and learn also. They don't want to become full-time students. They are more interested to combine their learning with other activities, or maybe they want to combine their learning of a core subject with allied subjects so that they can earn micro credentials or small degrees which will add value to their qualifications. So in a sense, I would say that there is a distinctiveness in the learning style, in the learning environment, in the whole perception of the learners of the 21st century. And as teachers, as mentors, as tutors, as counselors, it is our responsibility to accept and recognize this perception and attitude of the new learners of the 21st century and adopt new pedagogy in the teaching learning process. I think all of us should know that it is no more a teacher-centric system of education which is being followed in the 21st century. Rather, it is a learner-centric system of education. And in this learner-centric system of education, the attitude, the behavior, the learning style, and the perception of the learners needs to be understood very clearly by all of us. Then only we will be able to address to the demands and requirements of the learners of the 21st century. Thank you.